everyone doing tonight?
Good evening, everyone.
My name is Tom Smith. I'm your student body president, the general manager of 90.7 WXIN, and your host for this evening, Ed. Bobby, introduce yourself.
Hi, guys. I'm Rob. I'm the former student body president, also former general manager of WXIN. You know, this sounds really familiar.
We're both Robs. The things he said.
We have so much in common. I guess. So, how are you all doing tonight? Who's ready for Storgy's 2016? Everyone here is appropriately dressed for student life prom. Glad to see that this evening.
No one disappointed me tonight. Good job, everyone. Be proud of yourself.
You're already dressed better than both of us, so that's pretty okay.
I mean, that is true. This is thrown together at the last minute. I mean, come on. We all bought off the rack. We're very ashamed.
Wouldn't be proud of that. That's just me.
We had some help. There was some assistance with us.
So, Rob, I don't think everyone here really knows each other. I mean, student life.
It's a small town, but the town is not that small. Am I right, Rob?
I agree with that. So I think we need a somewhat icebreaker event.
Do you have something in mind?
Well, I think it's something that you should tell, because I think you have a more brain idea than I do.
Because between the two of us, I'm the young one and the pretty one.
Yeah, pretty much.
All right, so everyone's got a smartphone, right? Everyone hold up your smartphone.
Come on, folks, I got a smartphone.
It's your phone, it's got a touchscreen, it's an iPhone, it's an Android, it's a cell phone. I know you all got it.
This will not apply to all of you, but...
For your professors, it's a new class, okay? Everyone got them up? Okay.
Go ahead, Rob.
Open up Tinder. Come on. I know a lot of you have it. You don't want to know why. Everybody open up, come on.
Well, this is going to be fun.
It's a nice break, you're going to meet some people you haven't met before.
Set your radius to 1 mile.
Open up Tinder, set the radius to 1 mile. That should cover most of the room. And just start swiping right, just keep going for like 15 seconds.
And for those of you who don't have a social media app, talk to the people around you, like the only things you can do.
You know, like we used to do in the 20th century, like old people or something. So keep it up in mind for like 15 seconds, you'll find someone, trust me. If you're a girl, you'll get like a billion. If you're a guy, you'll get
best of luck next time.
And good luck, I've been on there, it's Rob.
So anyway, as I do that real quick, so Rob.
I'll have to give them the 15 seconds, come on.
They need something to do, never listen to us, so
yeah, give them, they are. They're not going to listen, guys. Give them the time to chat. Okay, everybody's done. Let's go on.
So anyway, Rob, you're student body president this year.
Yeah.
That's unfortunate.
No, but I got the job. Everyone said congratulations and my condolences.
I agree with that. So, but more importantly, because it's not all about you for once, we have the student clubs here this evening. Many of you here, glad to have you all here to watch us embarrass ourselves. Thank you for all coming out here tonight.
Because I don't do that on a daily basis.
So, let me see. Where is...
Alright, where's the media center? We'll get the easy one down earlier.
Oh, there they are.
Yeah, that was a hard one.
Alright. Where is the student community government table tonight?
What nerds?
Nerds. Right,
okay.
How about, where is the barroom table here tonight? They're going to impress us all and make us look awful later on tonight. But I look forward to that.
Who do we have here from Greek Life?
I think there might be a few people from Greek Life here tonight.
I don't know, I didn't hear anything.
I didn't hear anything either.
Pretty dead.
What was that? I didn't hear anything from Greek Life tonight. There we go. A little bit.
Not bad. Acceptable.
7 out of 10, 6 out of 10. You know. 6. So, anyway, let's see. Going around the room. How about programming! There we go.
Wow.
Thank you, Katie. Thank you for sharing our...
You're the true MVP from programming. Hey, and Mark didn't raise his hand.
Yeah, come on! He didn't raise his hand. I think he's going to use us in a little bit. We'll keep going here.
Well, you know.
Okay, hi, everyone. How about the adult room at the table, or the administration table?
Come on, say hi.
Thank you for coming along. Alright, so let's see. And let's see.
Are there any other faculty here who we missed? Please raise your hands and cheer.
My condolences to you.
Say woo, you're in college.
There you go. So anyway, hope you all have been enjoying the music so far provided by 90.7 WXIN. Playing all the greatest 70s music you want to hear.
Hey, a lot of those songs were from this decade, okay?
When you were in college?
I'm still in college for like another 14 days.
Speaking of people graduating, who here is graduating here this year?
That is an excellent
Wow. Student life can be some flashing. The rest of you need to start recruiting real quick. Anyway.
Anyway, guys, we just want to do the opening bit. My name's Rob. His name is Raul. We'll be hosting the awards this evening. We're going to go eat dinner now.
Take some bad jokes, you know.
They're going to be terrible puns, the likes of which you have never seen.
So thanks for putting up with us. Enjoy dinner, and I hope you guys have a good night.
We'll be back in like 20 minutes.
Yeah, for sure.
How was dinner? I don't speak cool. How actually was it? Mine was pretty good. Well, he didn't put his mic on. So who's ready for finals? Wow, the disclosure response makes me feel good.
Well, there we go.
All the finals still can't turn it on.
What's finals?
Yeah, I'm going to speak.
So, we all enjoyed dinner. Now, obviously no one here cares about finals. Well, hopefully next week we do, but maybe not for now. So, one more important thing. Who voted this past week here in Rhode Island, anyway?
Raise your hand.
Thank you for using your Democratic vote.
Maxine
action. So, all right. So, some of us voted, that was good. Who here doesn't vote? Nope, okay, that's good. No one submit that. That's good. That's really good. That was bad, I know. So anyway, now let me ask you this. Who here is happy with the results here in this past Tuesday in Rhode Island? Wow, a room full of Trump supporters. I will say though, some people were very surprised about the results this past Tuesday here in Rhode Island.
Why is that, Rob?
Well,
I'd like to take a minute. As you all know, Robert Tantori mentioned he's fantastic with bad dad jokes. So in honor of his bad dad jokes, we've created a nice bad dad joke countdown board.
Wait, what? Wait, what's this?
Uh-oh.
Night, though. I don't want to just tell them all at once.
So I have this feeling he'll get through those pretty quickly. So within the next 20 minutes, we should have him crowned Horrible Dad Joke King.
Okay, well, give me, you know, that's setting the expectations high, which for me is never a good thing. But
we never set expectations high for your body.
Wow. All right. All right, first one. How much does a polar bear weigh, folks? Enough to break the ice. Hi, I'm Rob. That's joke number one. That's pretty awful. Rob, do you have any bad dad jokes? Oh, wow. It's a countdown. Wait, what happens
when it gets one? What happens at zero?
What happens at zero?
Happy New Year?
I don't want to know. Okay.
Bobby, I think you've been ambushed.
I think I've been ambushed. Yeah, it's not a good thing.
Is this like the Raptors in Jurassic Park?
Yes.
I'm sorry. It's funny.
It's Jurassic World now, Rob. Jurassic Park's over with.
Same movie.
All right. So, what's
going on the dad joke?
They're all really bad. That's the only thing.
Come on, it's a pond.
All right. What did the ice cream cone say to the other ice cream cone?
I don't know what.
Ice to meet you.
Ow.
You suck.
I agree. Thank you, Elon. I also agree. This is actually a countdown. I gotta say eight more terrible dad jokes. Is that a goal? What's it? Is it like high or low? Is it Price is Right? I just gotta spin the wheel.
Do we have to put a quarter in a jar for every dad joke he said? Oh, she's shaking her head. Well, Lori, don't let her.
don't let her here. Give her a good
one. You can't do that.
All right. So I guess next dad joke. Let's see. What did the suit say to the other suit? Nice tie. Oh, let's just take that one off.
Ooh.
Oh,
Bobby.
This is just bad.
Where's tomato?
We're not.
Yeah, hope no one brought eggs this evening, otherwise it's going to end very poorly for me. All right. Rob, how about you tell a dad joke while I scramble here and look at my own jokes?
I'm not a dad.
Oh, come on, you're a dad to like 18 kids over there. Those are your kids right over there.
Yeah, but I'm not a dad. All right. Can I get a paternity test?
All right, so I have dad jokes. They're all really bad, actually. So let's see what else I have here. So I wrote down, and they're fully titled bad dad jokes, just in case we got to this point in the evening. All right, so what did the tomato say to the vegetable? No, that's my dad jokes. You can't take those away from me. What did the tomato say to the vegetable?
I don't know.
Tomato, tomato.
What?
Tomato, tomato.
Okay.
It's bad dad jokes. That's the thing.
They're all bad.
You know, I don't really want this going down to one. I might not live to see one. I might just have to leave. I don't know. So anyway. Liquid courage there, folks. So, taking a second there, who here really enjoys bad dad jokes? Just a choice. See, we got some here. Now, this one's support bad dad jokes room. Thank you guys over there, I really appreciate that. All right, who here enjoys good bad dad jokes, which are not totally my bad dad jokes?
Nobody.
There we go. Wow, shame the back. All right, so. What did the music note say to the other music note?
I don't know.
D minor.
What?
Yeah.
What?
Think about it. What? When you get it, you'll know.
What?
I'm not a musical man.
You're not a musical man. I can't sing or dance, so I don't think that counts. Uh-oh. Oh, no. I'm sorry. I didn't know I was supposed to be planning 10 bad dad jokes. Five? This is very bad, actually. All right. Give it up, don't pollute. All right. So, Rob?
Yes?
While we're watching me get totally annihilated here in front of about 200 people, how was your night going?
Well, I didn't give another bad dad joke real
quick.
I mean, it's all right. I'm dressed really nice. I enjoyed the food. Enjoyed the shade.
What did Charlie Brown order at a Chinese restaurant?
Do I want
chopsticks?
What?
It's wine.
You two are dying up here.
That was supposed to be actually. I'm getting to put some punishment right now. I don't know why. Wow, and we're down to hopefully 4. I gotta admit, by the way, I'm just gonna say for the record, I enjoy whoever actually drew these out. That's far more talent than I have here this evening. So,
yeah.
Anyway.
Hey, Bobby.
What?
Alright, I got one.
Uh-oh. Yeah, he has one. Bobby. Six jokes later,
Bobby.
But he has one.
Bobby.
Yep.
I'm a slow learner. It takes me a while, but I get there, just like you. That wasn't the joke.
I think it was, actually.
Bobby, alright, it's related to history, okay? You ready for it?
Yeah.
Stop looking at your phone.
I'm on Facebook.
Who are you texting?
I'm looking on Facebook. We're trending. It's not good, though. I'm not right now.
Alright, I got the joke.
Okay.
Show your mouth, okay? What's a Babylonian urn?
What?
I don't know, but more than me.
Wow, even I
four
have to walk away at that one.
4 years of history classes, that's what I learned.
That's pretty bad, I'm not gonna lie. That was pretty bad. Okay, we're down to what, 3 now? All right.
I don't know what happens at 3.
I'm really curious what's gonna happen at 0.
I'm afraid
of
God
returns
to get
pumped. So I get hit with like a tomato? A pine?
You ruined this suit, I will never forgive you.
Rob cares more about his clothes than people.
You can ruin his.
So, on to the better things of the evening.
I agree.
We're actually going to have our MCs present the next award, which is for Best Social Event.
Alright.
The award for Best Social Event is presented to the event that best promotes social interaction between all members of the college community.
I brought my own lawyer, thank you.
Wow, we're doing fun. The nominees are Festival of Lights, sponsored by the Academy Association, Active Minds, Advocacy and we're not doing all the folks. Advocacy and Beyond, American Marketing Association, Anchor TV, Apple Post.
read it once for the benefit of those who are reading.
Association, Ballroom Dance Club, Biology Club, Ready Books to Life, Cape Verdean Student Association, CAF Coalition, Delphi Epsilon, English Club, Premis United, the Games and Merriment Enthusiasts of RIP, Ocean State Film Society, Otaku, Flying the Delta, Poli Sci Club, Brickset, Sojourn, Moon of Color, and 90.7 WXIM.
You sure you got them all there?
Is there anyone in the room we missed?
So anyway, other two nominees this evening are RIP Week 2015, sponsored by the Programming Event Board and the Resident Student Association. Come on, guys, give it up. And the third and final nominee is the Welcome Week 2016, which is also sponsored by the Programming Event Board. And when it goes, the award goes to, Rob, open the envelope, take the Oscars, get over there.
Am I kind of white?
Yes. Come on, pull the letter away. Who won? Went out of three? All right, one, two, three.
Storgy Award, Rob, you're not.
The Storgy Award
for Best Social Event goes to
Festival of Lies! Give them award! All right, so we're going to make this organized. Send one representative, right guys? One representative from each club up here that won this evening to take their award. Please, be orderly, be fashion, be ritzy. We bring enough awards? Is there free food up here I'm missing? I think we'll be ready and prepared in the next 5 minutes after we're going to say awards. Guys, while everyone's finishing getting the awards, give a big round of applause for getting to Festival of Lights for putting on a great social event this year. As you can see, ASA is the main co-sponsor for a lot of the awards this evening. So we'll be reading the nominees every time, but you guys know where they are. Alright, so, well, I think the actual host of this evening just went over there real quick. So I'm going to talk to you guys for just a second. Who here is part of multiple clubs here on campus? Great, quick show of hands. Wow, a lot of people have no free time then. That's great to hear. Now let me ask this. Who here is part of three organizations here on campus? Wow, okay, we're doing pretty good so far. How about four organizations on campus? Okay, I'm still seeing some hand raises. Do you people sleep? I don't think so.
Do you people go to class?
Do you go to class?
Yeah.
I did. Did you?
I went to class.
Okay. I mean, I graduated, so I used to go to class sometime.
My professor would recognize me.
I don't know, mine might not. Maybe.
He called me Scott a couple times, but I mean, I could look like a Scott, right?
You look like a Scott.
I could look like a Scott.
So anyway, after that first award, I think the better question is, now when is dessert?
Wait, is dessert?
No, I don't think but Bob just found out there's dessert, which is probably the best news he'll get all evening. But anyway. Might be too long, don't worry, they watch it on Netflix and just binge the whole thing over the course of 2 hours and just skip all of our parts and just see the actual awards. Nah, that's not
no.
Oh, next award? You want to say, okay. So, right, so, excuse me, well, let me just grab the list real quick. Time to visit. All right, and next up to present the Best Cultural Event Award is the RIP Ballroom Dance speaker, Shane Henry Krellen. Give him a round of applause, ladies and gentlemen. Experience for the college community. A great award. And the nominees are
Creole Speaking Event, sponsored by the Cape Verdean Student Association.
And we also have Debate Watch, sponsored by the Political Science Club.
And last but not least, the Eye Opening Experience Access Challenge, sponsored by the Advocacy and Beyond Club.
Sorry about that, folks, that was all me. So anyway, we're gonna have Christy Sackle come here to present the award itself. That was our part, folks, my apologies. Give Christy a round of applause, because we are awesome.
Thank you.
it up for ABC, everybody. Give a loud round of applause also to Jose, because he is next year's SCG student becoming president. I did do that, and I will say real quick, the Access Challenge won the best events here we had at Rhode Island College. If you haven't had a chance to participate in it, definitely take your chance to do so in the fall or spring next year. So anyway, Rob, I think we're going here to the program now. What's the next event coming up next? Who's presenting next?
Next category is Best Fundraiser, presented by Emma Holman. Where are you, Emma?
Come on up, you're next down, the Price is Right. Round of applause real quick to Gamer for their Extra Life Play Game Steal Kids event that was popular. I think Gamer and Otaku do a great job every year, I think. I think they've been doing the event, what, 2 or 3 years now for the charity event?
Absolutely. I wasn't listening to him. I never knew what was he saying.
He never listens to me, but it's whatever. Oh, Gamer's over there, Otaku's over there. Oh, jeez. So anyway. Coming up next, we have Best Public Service. And to present that award is Jason Windrow. Jason, come on down. Where are you, Jason? Come on. This man is impeccably dressed this evening. Much better than me, for sure. He's definitely pulling up the opportunity.
Those shoes!
Thing. We're gonna go around here real quick. fortunes really quick. I mean, I'd go for the fortune too, but I'm also hungry. I have to actually read your fortune out loud, but that's the only thing. You picked it, you gotta read it, come on. Don't be shy now.
You are neither better, deceptive or crazy.
That's a pretty good fortune, better than mine. What is your name?
Deanna.
All right, Deanna, so what is your fortune there?
A beautiful person is with you. Confide your problems.
It's entering.
Wow, that's inaccurate, then. I feel sorry for them. The factory's sometimes wrong.
So we have a very brave soul here to talk about the So introduce yourself.
My name is Jose Hurtado.
And what club are you with?
Biology Club.
Yay, science.
My question is, will I get into medical school this
year? All right, now. Wow, that's a little too deep in the eight ball, I think, but we're going to see what's happening here.
Let's see. The answer is, it is uncertain.
No, shake it in. No, shake it again. Shake it again.
Second try.
No. That's we'll give him the mulligan here. It's fine.
Most likely.
There we go. We know this guy's in medical school, so he's fine. All right, so who's next up here on the list? Who else wants to be a brave soul? Right, so let's go this side real quick. We'll make our way around.
So we have our lovely Mary Samovia.
Oh.
She wants Magic 8-Ball.
All right. That's a no, I can tell you that right now.
Alright. The reading's not clear.
I think it's pretty murky at best.
Outlook not so.
I agree with that, and it's actually pretty accurate. Alright, so we have a fortune over here. I heard fortune over here. You know, I think it looks good, though. It's your color. Well, why she's opening that, and what it. Well, tell us here, for those who don't know here, and who are you to see?
Hi, I'm Katie.
Well, let's give her a round of applause for being brave, still for getting the cookie. Now, remember, you have to actually eat the cookie, though, it's the only thing.
A journey must begin with a single step.
Wow, okay, that's actually a really good fortune. It sounds like one of those inspirational quotes, but that's pretty good. Just let it apply to where you want to apply to. All right, we have someone over here. All right, and my friend, who might you be, sir?
I'm Chris Ames, and I'm a buzzer gamer.
All right, let's give Chris a round of applause and a brave soul. All right, so, Chris, what do you want this evening? Magic 8-Ball it is. Uh-oh. So what do you want to ask him, though? Why are you shaking? What do you want to ask him, though?
Am I the most dapper one here?
Oh, is he the most dapper one here tonight? Let's find out.
The answer is yes!
Oh! That is what we call a winner. All right, couple more. For now, you know, we get some more later, don't worry. Let's go around, let's see some hands this way. Make it where now, don't worry. Where? All right, we go here real quick. Don't worry, folks, there's enough much cookies for all of you, I think. Maybe not, actually. You want a fortune, horoscope? Don't spell your horoscope yet, actually. Virgo. Okay, what month is Virgo, though?
So, based on what you mean, most likely you're moving in the bottom there.
That is a very accurate eerie. Come on, guys, give it up. What's so eerie right now? Alright, we're gonna go wait for at least two more, put next to one. We'll come back to this stuff. And what is your name? Is this? Lauren, okay, Lauren. And what do you want to eat? Fortune cookies. You know what, Jason? I don't think we get enough fortune cookies. I'm not gonna lie. So, what are you hoping to find from your fortune? Good news, bad news, maybe news?
Great news.
Okay, well, let's see about that. I don't know. Jason, let me ask you that. How many cookies you got left in there? You're going pretty quick, I'm not gonna lie. Alright, so we got your fortune out loud there.
You cannot be anything if you want to be everything.
I felt that right here, the Disney motivational spirit. Alright, so, Two more. All right, we're gonna go right here. Jason, you get to pick the one next to you. We have two more left at the moment. Which one do you want to do? Anyone? Anyone else? Oh, President Cariello. What do you want? Fortune, horoscope? She wants both. Well, she is the president of us. You can ask her for it. Otherwise, she might not pass. I'm not gonna lie. All right, so Jason, how are you liking your team so far? You've been doing pretty well. You haven't embarrassed us yet, the genie. But where's your lamp, I'm wondering? All right, President Bill, what do you have for a fortune there?
Learn Chinese today. Where are you, patient man?
That's actually really solid. I'm not really sure about that. All right, and what is your astrological sign?
Taurus. And what month is Taurus? May.
Right, May also is actually coming up very soon.
So, the Taurus is
in the preservation.
And things are getting a little rocky, but they'll be stable soon, and you'll do good on all your concerned
areas. Does Saturn come close this time? That's not a question. Does Saturn come close this time of year?
Yes.
Okay, it's good enough. Okay, we have one more, I see hand over there. All right, one more, then we'll go back to the actual awards, the everyone here is obviously here for. And what is your name, this?
Stephanie.
All right, Stephanie, and which do you want to see, horoscope or, yeah. Fortune, all right. Not enough praise for this horoscope, though. That's true, they didn't give me, although I think you're going to run out of fortunes very soon, unless you're going to eat them all yourself. Probably, that would be more soon.
You'll spend many more years at Rick.
Wow. That got really deep.
Program.
Club, everybody. Wasn't that a magnificent performance, Bobby? Why don't you dance like that? Once again, you can't turn it on.
Nope, there we go. Let's give it up again for Barm Dance, man. That was really impressive.
None of us in here could do that. I certainly couldn't.
You know, I did a ballroom event once.
I drew a good stage. Oh, it's about you?
Yeah, it's about you. Once
great, I drew a great safety dance, let me tell you.
But don't do the bumping ground. Just don't do that. So one time, I actually did a ballroom thing, but I peaked early. I tied for fourth, and I think that was the end of my ballroom career. So anyway, next up here in the program this evening, we have Best on Campus of Program, and the award, and who's going to be saying that, Rob? Tell us here.
And it looks like it's going to be Jason again. Jason, where'd you go?
No, on campus. It says on campus.
Yeah,
maybe
that
a public school student, but I agree.
I'm so glad some of us
did.
Jason, our genie, let's give our genie a round of applause.
Jason, why'd you make that?
The nominees are Carnival, Cookies with Creativity, Festival of Lights, and Ice Cream Giveaway.
Drum roll, guys, drum roll. And who's the winner?
Festival of Lights.
Whoa! Festival of Lights! Okay, everyone, orderly line. Everyone has a store, give me spirits, enough for all of you. Of course, that is Festival of Lights' third win here this evening here at Storgy's.
Round of applause.
I think, yeah, come on, guys, round of applause. I think they might be running away with it.
No, Bobby, I've never seen the Don this before.
Well, I mean, I think it's free food up here. Is it free ice cream?
I don't think you can eat that.
I don't think so either. Thank God we're caught by the music right now. Okay, I'm just going to warn you, do not dance or sing along to the Spice Girls. Oh, I said that. No.
I won't say.
No!
I said I wouldn't say.
I don't trust you.
Hey, you're not saying no, anybody can say.
Yeah, and now who knows how to listen to Spice Girls? Oh, no, we're not going to sing along. I can sing as well as I can dance. No. Don't worry, guys, we're going to keep playing music here for a second as more people try and find those programs this evening.
Yeah.
So anyway, Rob, what are you thinking of the award list? I think they're all very deserving, don't you?
Yeah, they're good events.
I got to say, I think they're pretty much all well attended. Now let me ask you, though.
Yeah.
I noticed that Festival of Lights has a lot of attendees. I think we have to give a second to talk. Where's the ASA room this evening? There's the ASA. There we go. I think they really represent the whole co-sponsoring thing here on this campus, just a little bit.
It's good to see collaboration among the young
people. It really is.
But young people?
Really? No. Well, actually, yeah, you're kind of old.
Is that old? How old am I?
Third?
The hesitation in your voice makes me worried.
I do too. So,
Bobby, what's next award?
So, next award is Best Off-Campus Event. And it's being presented by our own one and only. Wait, is he here?
He's right there.
Ken Jr. Come on now. I gotta give him credit. Ken here is one of the few people I know who can magnificently qualify bow tie. I'm sure he deserves a round of applause for that. Here you go, Ken.
Thank you. Hello, everyone. How's everyone doing tonight? Excellent. Just have to say, you all look fantastic.
So do you!
Anyway, not about us, about this. The award for Best Off-Campus Program is presented to the program that hosts the most successful program on campus.
That's good.
The nominees are Dave & Buster's Back to School Bash, sponsored by a Gamer. Okay. Montreal Trip, Fall 2015, brought to us by the programming event. Alright, and the Rick Ballroom Dance Competition, brought to us by the Rick Ballroom Dance Team. Alright, let's see if I go over this thing.
I started it now.
I got one that I think everyone's going to relate to.
Does anyone in the room know what a deja vu is? Anybody? Anybody at all? I'm hearing yeses, but I'm not hearing any actual answers.
I'm hearing boos. Might want to tell them.
It's when you've heard all this bull before.
Okay, I'm going to say a better one. Are cats empathetic because they're feline? Oh no, that's gonna bomb. Anyway, next up, we have the best new organization on campus this year, and that is gonna be vetted by our own editor-in-chief-elect. I believe she's over there in the corner, right? Louisa!
Did it.
member in an organization. And the presenter is our own Thomas Lebon.
T-U-F, come on, come on. He's making a song, he's got a song to play. What a true guy.
T-U-N-I-S.
Come on, Tom. You have all day, come on.
The man who gets the best of himself, Thomas Lebon. Come on, Tom.
Thank you, TV.
How we doing? Presented to the student who makes the greatest contribution to the college community and his or her respective organization. The nominees are Nat Coakley of Bringing Books to Life, Julian Gomestick of the Ballroom Dance Club, Robbie Rose of WXMA, and Matthew Rivers Brown of the Asian Student Association. The award goes to... Come on, Tom.
Sometime today, Tom.
Julian Gomestick, a Ballroom Dance Club.
Shane is dressed better than most. I think actually he's dressed better than all of us.
It's not completely.
Let's give it a round. You don't get me. Let's give it a round to Julian.
Give it a round to Julian. You know he's here.
Life force this campus. Now, mind you, you might have noticed we've now moved to the individual awards of this evening.
Yes.
So, those of you out there, you start to get really interested. So, Rob, we just gave away the most dedicated member of the room. What's next?
The next award which we presented is most active freshman to be presented by Amanda Holland.
He gave me his best shot. Yeah.
It's usually friends of which name.
Making friends of here, Rob.
Come up here, Amanda.
Thank you. I swear. So anyway, next up is a very special award, not one a lot of people know right away, but it's a very great award. It is the most dedicated non-POM member of Student Community Government, and the person presenting that is our own Anchor TV GM, Patrick Kerr. I like the blue, Patrick.
Thank you. Okay, where's the thing?
It's right below there. No, the one on the right. The right. There we go.
Each year, one SCG committee member who is not a parliament member is selected by both parliament and non-parliament committee members for the award of most dedicated non-parliament committee member. This person went above and beyond what their position in the committee requires. They also work well with the SCG Executive Council, the committee chair, and other committee members. This year's recipient is a truly deserving individual. The 2015-2016 most dedicated non-parliament committee member is...
One more drum roll, come on. Better, where's your school?
Most dedicated non-parliament committee member goes to Christy Sackle, student organization.
Woo! Come on, Christy, guys! You know, put this shindy guy tonight.
Do you see who's next? No, let me see.
You have to announce it.
So the next award is the most dedicated parliament member. This is an award that typically goes to a parliament member who is dedicated. And the presenter is
thanks for that.
Bobby Centuri Jr.
I don't want to hear my voice again. That's
you already have the mic until you have your left shoulder, Bobby.
That's my entrance right there.
Hey,
I'm coming back there.
I love Nelly, right?
No one loves Nelly, this one's fine, right?
I know I like you, Nelly. Come on.
Thanks, Dan Fam. So anyway, every year, one, and I hope you guys can take me seriously with the hat, by the way. I think it clashes well with my outfit, but that's fine with me. So anyway, every year, one student member of Palmer who is not an officer of SCG shall be selected for the award of most dedicated Palmer member. Palmer members agreed that this person went above and beyond what their position requires. This person works well with Parliament, the organization, and the administration. And this year's recipient is a truly deserving individual. And the 2015-2016 most dedicated Parliament member is, well, drum roll, as I try to get my arm up here. I'm just gonna drop on the phone. Well then, the Storgy Award for most dedicated Palm member goes to Jose Rosario! Jose, give a big hand to the award! Come here, buddy!
Look at me, I'm fucking nerd. No one? That was big 10 years ago.
Oh my god, it was 10 years ago? Let's give it again for Jose, who is truly an example of a student leader here on campus, and most dedicated Palm member.
I've been waiting for this 10 years ago. I was in high school then.
Were you?
I'm about to play Social Security.
And it won't be there for
is
you,
there
sorry.
Is there
it won't be there for you.
Bobby,
you
missed
the sorry, you said the king of bad jokes. You are dating the queen of bad jokes.
But this doesn't matter.
Actually, hey, that's like a Nest hat. You need the outfit.
Hold on. What are you doing here?
Hold on. I'm spinning thing on top. Give me a second. Nope. Did you get a set? Where'd you get this? This is not very good.
Is this from Dollar?
I can't spin right. Okay, Maria, you're going to... Maria, I think that's doing very well. This is why wind powers don't work, people. Anyway.
So the queen...
What? I'm the king for once. Sorry.
That's
so anyway, the next award is the Beverly McGinnis Scholarship, and that is going to be presented by our own student government president and queen of awful jokes.
I am not queen.
Sorry, queen of awful jokes, Robert J. Smith. Come on, Rob. Junior.
Tell bad jokes. It gets the people going. Thank you.
McGinnis dedicated 22 years of her life working in student community government. She was one of, among SCG's first employees. She served a long, long time. I know for a lot of us millennials, 22 years in a job seems almost unheard of, but she put in some really great service back in the day. She was a wonderful woman who truly enjoyed working with her students. When she passed in 2003, student community government renamed that scholarship the Beverly L. McGinnis Scholarship in her honor. So to get this is a great award. Each year, SCG awards two scholarships to individuals who personify a commitment to Rhode Island College, to the community, to the academics, and to themselves. This year's Beverly L. McGinnis Scholarship goes with, well, this year's recipients are Bobby Open. I don't get one.
Oh, okay.
Now I can double fist two mics. The award is significant, guys. I know a lot of us could go to break. It's hard to pay for college, but this helps at least two students pay their way for next year. So this year's Beverly L. McGinnis Scholarships go to, and if you win, please come up, Brittany Frizzoco and Jason Windrow. Come on down, guys. The next award, while Bobby finds it, even though it's on top, is the most outstanding advisor.
Give us a moment here, Sammy. I got to
admit, looking how he's made this, I don't know how he graduated, Rick.
I don't either. So, hold on, guys, we're losing awards here. We have a lot of people.
Wait, I'm going to introduce the man. Bobby, you ready? You guys find it? Oh my god, it looks like my back.
Almost.
I am graduating.
Do we find it? Nope, that's not it. Go ahead, Rob.
So while they search the award, I'm just the man introducing the award tonight. He's in a dangerous piece of grit. The Silver Fox himself, Dr. Scott Kane.
Sorry, folks, hold on a second.
Dr. Kane is your intern vice president of student affairs and the dean of students.
Yeah.
So the nominees are Mark Paolucci for the Programming Event Board, Arthur Patry for WXIA, and then Karen Rossi Detremont for Advocacy at Beyond. And the winner is Mark Paolucci for Programming Event Board.
Give it up, guys, give it up! Give her a round of applause, everyone. Best secretary of the year. All right, now the next position is the unsung hero position, I'd say.
Is it me?
No.
Best girl Smith on campus?
It's the best, it's the person who has to handle all the money, which is never a happy position. And then next award is best treasurer. And who better to present than our own student government treasurer, Noah Costin! Also, the treasurer of the Rick Ballroom Dance Team.
Asian Student Association.
And the Storgy Award for Greg President goes to...
me!
Drum roll, come on, it's important to work out, drum roll. This is your award ceremony for you guys. Linda Lin of the Asian Student
and unfortunately, Linda could not be here this evening, but one of the members who's been here on behalf. Let's give her another round of applause to Linda for leading ASA this year. As you can clearly see from the Stony Battle this year, they did a very fine job on it. So, I'm going to take my exit here, but the last award of the evening is, of course, anyone have a guess?
Come on, we'll take guesses.
Yeah. Organization of the Year. So the entire student community executive board come here. Oh, look, they're all right here. I think they planned this or something.
Fantastic.
All right, folks, come here.
So where's the envelope, guys? Lenore is tall enough, he doesn't need the stage. So the award for Organization of the Year recognizes a contributions of a particular organization during the year in all respects, including active membership, creative ideas, quality of programs, and overall contributions of the college and its students. The nominees are... Everybody listening? I want to run out your Snapchat files. The nominees are the Asian Student Association. Very good, clapping, yes. Cape Verdean Student Association. And 9.7 WXIN. And the award for Organization of the Year goes to the Asian Student Association. Come on down, guys.
And again, a really special
Well, until the battery goes out. Those things have a half life of like 3 years. American manufacturing. Man, where did it go? Thanks, Captain. Is that for political?
Yes.
Oh, well, whatever. Let me come back up here. All right, well, Bobby, how many words are left? I don't think there are any left, are there?
Maybe. I don't think so. Let's see. Oh. Let's see, no, there actually, there are no awards left on
there. There are no awards?
So what does that mean though, Ralph?
What?
What does that mean though? There's no awards left.
I guess you can get to talk more.
No, I don't think that's a good idea.
Come down here.
I don't think talking's a good
idea.
I don't think talking's a good idea.
Come on.
Wait, what are we doing? What's going on here?
I'm just gonna go with it. I'm just gonna go.
I have a hat on.
Come on, this is improv. It's calm in its finest.
Are we gonna have a rap battle? I don't want a rap battle. I'm not gonna
lie. I can't do a rap battle. Unless it's
no.
We're not going to do a rap battle.
No, rap battle.
We're not going to do a rap battle.
Okay, so what's the plan here? You're leading me here because I have no idea. If this is ball, I'm going to lead down the ball.
What is this?
Come
on.
I mean.
Take it off?
No. Keep it on.
The administration is present. We cannot take it off.
Keep it on.
We got to keep this PG-13 for the viewers of Anchor TV.
All right. So. Wow. Maybe she's the host, so she's pretty funny. Anyway.
I'm not Ronnie Dangerfield, I get no respect.
You have to deserve it first. But anyway, on that note, I think we never got a good way to end this evening, but in all seriousness for a moment, I'd like to thank everyone who attended here this evening. Don't leave yet. I'd like everyone to attend this evening. You guys are the lifeblood student life here at Allen College. You all should be proud of yourselves for the events you put on and everything that you do. But the show is not over yet. Why not, Rob?
Pokemon battle!
Not quite. No, in the lobby, maybe, if you really want to.
For those of us who are interested, they will be dancing afterward. The bar is still open. When is the bar open until lobby?
So I drink it all the bar? But no more alcohol? I don't know.
I don't know, Bobby. I need a time frame for that. Here comes Lori.
Here comes Lori now, the actual person.
So the heels came off, which means it's time to dance.